Yes, because he gave her space. If you put the both of them on a scale, now babe will pick C over P and Pereira is very fine. That's why I asked him. He doesn't look or appreciate himself in a mirror. He looks like a Pereira, but he has a personality of a weakling. He should...
Wait, 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 well, I don't talk on before, and I said it's a Pereira.
No, the conversation started. Ceec and Mercy were talking about it. I walked into them. I joined. I was the one that said that battle. But I said, Pere, it looks like Pere. But he's personality that he has a weekly. And then Alex walked in. And she also said something. I can't remember exactly what she said. But before I was having that conversation, but that beginning part of Ceec, I don't remember. I walked into Mercy talking. And Ceec talked. And I talked. So maybe I got the question for my head. I said, I'm doing. Because it's always easy. Because doing your girlfriend. Everyone said, that's
oh, your friend.
What color are you?
Yes, he was stretched. It was confusing at the beginning.
Yes. Shout out first here. Welcome to this video. Yesterday was really a violence headquarters at the Big Brother house. All thanks to the parrot. Everybody has been asking, when is this parrot going to talk again? Is the parrot dead? Well, yesterday, Big Brother resurrected the parrot. And trust me, it was really a violence headquarters. The parrot revealed some conversation that Doyin, Alex, Ceec, and of course, Neo had about in the triangle between or among Cross, Pere, and Kim. Of course, that conversation didn't go well. And the parrot aired the conversation to the whole house. And of course, the fight between Doyin and Kim. I was expecting even, Cross to be the one who is supposed to flare up. Because, I mean, he was also the one at the verge of receiving basketballs aside, Pere receiving some insult from Doyin. Trust me, it was really a whole lot for Pere to take for him to start tearing up. Now, Doyin on the other hand, Kim on the other hand also felt insulted and attacked Doyin. And Doyin on the other hand, she's a straight talker. She immediately admitted that, look, yes, she's the one that said, Pere is behaving like a Whitney. Now, the whole house thought Doyin said Pere is behaving like a weakly. So, weakling and Whitney are two different things. Now, Doyin went ahead to explain to Cross after the pool party that, look, yes, she's the one that said it, but she didn't say weakly. She said Whitney. Whitney in a terms of, Pere behaving like a softie, like a girl because of Kim and stuff like that. And also, they went ahead to explain the situation that, Pere told them, the ladies that are called as Alex, Ceec, Doyin, of course, Mercy, that Cross is aware that him, Pere, like Kim, and Cross like Nengi. Now, for Kim to come into the house and Cross to take over, Abby, Cross him, and take over Kim from him, that is like by stabbing his friend in the back, so he wasn't cool with that. So the whole conversation surrounding friend betraying friend because of a girl, that is all the conversation was all about. So in a nutshell, in a summary, Kim is angry at Kim is angry at Doyin. Now after the pool party, the guys, that's Pere, tried to have a conversation with Kim and Cross, talking about the whole situation again. At the end of the day, there was no even head and tail. There was no conclusion. There was no concise conclusion about what exactly the way forward. Is he going to back out? Is he going to back in? Is he going to, like, there was nothing, conclusive about that conversation. They just talk about the whole situation, as in how the girls are talking about them, the triangle and stuff like that. And what is the way forward? The way forward was that, Cross on the other hand is that was still acting oblivious, acting like he didn't know what was going on. And in a way, Angel even had to tell Cross that, you need to stand your ground, you need to take a stand, you need to tell people where you stand in terms of all this situation. Are you in and out? And also, if Kim doesn't care about you, she wouldn't be spending much time with you either. She also enjoyed the attention she's getting from both of you, and she also knows that both of you are parties, are friends for life. So she doesn't, she's basically playing you two need to decide what you want to do in this house, or maybe you play along, and when you go out, you decide what you want to do. Now, the friendship between, you know, Pere and Cross has been a little dicey in this season, and both of them seems like they are still cool. According to Cross yesterday, he said, well, he's just going to play along, go see how it goes. When he goes out, he will decide exactly, or he will see things for himself, he will see things for himself and decide exactly what he wants to take the friendship with Pere to or not. So in all of this, there's no exactly conclusion. The fact that, you know, everybody knows that more these girls are talking about the triangle is well. And one thing that I was annoyed about is the fact that Pere was crying yesterday. I mean, I really do not see the need for him to cry when he has already told the girls the situation himself. So it's all acting for me. For me, it's all acting. I just like the fact that the girls or the ladies who gossiped about or talked about the situation own up to saying things, you know, that, yeah, they said things about that situation. And yes, so that was some update from the parrot. All thanks to the parrot, we had some little action from the housemates last night, and it was really exciting to see, you know, all the housemates admitting what they said behind their back. So watch out for the part two of the revelation of the parrot. Yes, the parrot talked a lot, two parts, actually yesterday. So guys, I'll see you in the next video.